Hello and welcome back, audience. My name is Massive Brad and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool Grey Mode. Now, before we jump into today's game against Norwich in the Capital One Cup Round 4, I just want to say a huge big thank you as always for the love and support on the channel, guys. And if you do enjoy today's video, please do give it a big thumbs up for me. Drop your comments down below if you're new around here. Click that subscribe button. Don't forget to share the video with your friends and family. And guys, before we dive into the game against Norwich, I just want to say that for the last probably 5-6 minutes, I've been keeping an eye on the in real life Capital One Cup. Everton are playing Norwich and currently drawing 1-1. Hull are playing Leicester, that's still 0-0. Sheffield are beating Arsenal 3-0. And Stoke are beating Chelsea 1-0, which is absolutely insane. I don't know what's going on. I don't know if Arsenal maybe put their B team out. I don't know if Chelsea have. But some of those scores are absolutely mental. For Sheffield to be beating Arsenal 3-0, that is absolutely crazy. And guys, I just want to say a huge big thank you for all the support that you've given me on Benteke in the comment section of the last video, because there's lots of mixed views. People saying, Brad, look at offloading and bring Suarez back. Go after Lacazette. The problem with Lacazette, guys, is he's only just moved to Man United. So he's probably not going to want to look at moving again unless we pay Man United a load of money, which is never going to happen. Suarez would be a brilliant player to bring back to Anfield. Problem is, again, he's going to cost me probably 20, 30 million as well as Benteke just to lure him away from Barcelona. Benzema's probably going to be a difficult one. I know he's probably going to cost me 40, 50 million. But then the other half of the views were, Brad, keep hold of him, stay with him, support him, and he'll get back to his scoring ways. People have told me that he scored 26 goals for them in a season. But one comment stood out for me the most, and that's what I'm going to look at. Somebody said, Brad, go to your squad report, have a look at Benteke, because when I first joined Liverpool, he wasn't very happy. His morale said insecure, which means his head isn't in the right place. He feels insecure. He doesn't feel that he can do his job properly, and that's a bit of a problem. What they said to me is if you keep playing him, you keep training him, and you look after him, and you know, you don't drop his confidence more than it already is, he will get back into form. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to go over to the squad report and have a look. And as you can see there, guys, in the office, we do have one email. But unfortunately, when I was simulating all the way to this game, I seen a message appear in the top left from Martin Skirtle saying, boss, we need to talk. And I'm hoping, I'm fingers crossed, that he is not asking for a transfer request to be put in because we haven't been playing him. I'll be absolutely gutted if that is the case. But nevertheless, we're going to jump into the squad report. We're going to try and find Benteke. There was also another player then. Look at that. See, Kolo Touré, his form's poor and he's unhappy, and that's why he's coming back into the team today. And there he is, Christian Benteke. And look at that, guys. His morale is insecure. His head is not right. It's not in the right place, and that's why he's not scoring goals. So I think that we have to stick with him, and then we have to keep him positive, keep him happy, and we just have to keep going with it. And that's why I've left him in the team for today, guys. We've got Benteke up front. We've got Lallana, Coutinho and Firmino behind him. We've then got Chan and Tielemans making their way into the central defensive midfield roles. Gomez, Skirtle, Torre's in the team, obviously, because I don't want to leave him out. And because it's the Capital One Cup, I want to bring the youngsters in. That's why I brought Gomez back in for Moreno. And obviously, Klein's playing it right back with Mignolet in goal. But what we're going to do is we're going to jump over to the office. And there we go, Martin Skirtle with the subject. May I speak to you about something? Oh, no. Please don't be bad. Yes, I am unsettled at the moment, boss. Oh, no. I cannot deny that. I want to make sure everything is open between us, that you know exactly what is going on. I'm trying to sort my head out, but it is honestly not easy when home is so far away, you know. I haven't said anything to my agent because I want to concentrate on training hard and seeing what happens. The most important thing to me is that I continue to do a good job for you and the team. Well, I appreciate that, Martin Skirtle. Again, this is just one of those things on FIFA. He's been at Liverpool. He's been a Liverpool player for 7 years. I can't see after being in another country for 7 years. You'd really be that homesick after 7 years. It just seems a bit mad for me. I know if you go away for a week or two, sometimes you get a bit homesick, but 7 years. I mean, in real life, he's got a wife, he's got kids, and he lives in Liverpool, so I don't understand why he would be homesick. But nevertheless, this is FIFA for you guys. Hopefully he won't leave, and if he does, okay, it's a bit of a loss for us, but we have got the likes of Varane, we've got Zouma, we've got Sakho, we've even got Torre, so we have got backup centre-back, so we're not going to be stuck thinking, oh no, what we're going to do, we need to buy a quick centre-back, because we don't. Luckily we signed Varane, who's a brilliant signing, playing a bit poor at the moment, but was a decent signing, and obviously we've got Zouma, who we brought in as the youngster to eventually replace Skirtle. So it's not too bad really, you know, it's one of those things where if he wants to go, then he has to go. It's just one of them. There's nothing we can do about it. But we're going to play in our black away kit. They can play in their home kit. And fingers crossed, we can progress again through the Capital One Cup, guys, and hopefully Benteke can start getting his head in the right place and possibly score a goal or two in today's episode. Let's get into this.
We're now down to
here we go, lads. Norwich versus English Liverpool at Carrow Road. Can Benteke find his form today? I am so hoping that he can, because if he can't, we're going to have to drop him from the team. And guys, I know a lot of people have been saying, like, you know, keep him in the team, Brad, keep him happy. Guys, we need someone to score goals. We're not doing amazingly at the moment in the Barclays Premier League, and we definitely need to find a routine where we have goals in the team. But fingers crossed, today's the day. Benteke gets his head back in the game. He starts feeling comfortable at that striker position, and he can bag a goal or two. Let's get into this first half, and fingers crossed we can get something out of it. Oh no, he's cut your back. He cut your back. That was not great. Come on, Klein. And Mignolet have a huge save after just 4 minutes. Come on, Tielemans. Oh, referee. Thank you very much. Free kick. Tell you what, if we could whip this in for Benteke on his head. Yellow card for the Norwich left back. Right. Where's Benteke? Benteke is probably going to be edge of the 6-yard box, maybe. Let's just whip a ball in. Come on, Firmino. Nice ball in. In for Benteke. Back post. Oh, no. And he falls to the floor, and you can see in his face he is so desperate to get a goal, lads. He is trying everything, and we've tried everything, crossing it into him, giving it to him in his feet. He just does not know where the net is at the moment. But oh, Coutinho's robbed him. Coutinho edge of the box on his left foot, and it's took a deflection. Oh, I thought that was our chance then. It was on Coutinho's weaker foot, but I thought this is a chance. Right, here he is, the main man, Benteke. Come on, Benteke, get your head on that, please. A little bit far, Colo. Oh, and it's coming into Colo. Unlucky. Is it going to help? Oh, it is. It's another corner. This time, Benteke's on the edge of the penalty box. Come on, whip a ball in. It's Colo again. Oh, it's Firmino. It's Roberto Firmino, probably the second smallest guy in the box after Coutinho. And he manages to climb above the defender. I actually thought Colo Torre scored that, guys. Comes in. No, it is. It's Firmino coming in front post. Heads it to the back post. And it's a beautiful header over Ruddy. What an absolutely incredible goal. And guys, we are 1-0 up right before the first period is coming to an end. Here's Benteke. Plays it inside for Lallana. Go on, Lallana. Play it. Nice. Give it for Benteke. Benteke edge of the box. Right foot. Oh, what a strike. Play it in. Can we pick out Coutinho? He has picked out Coutinho. Hold it up. Fake shot, Coutinho. Nicely done. Coutinho on his right foot and drills it across the face of goal, but nowhere near the target. Unlucky Coutinho. Close it down, lads. And there we go. Referee has blown. The first period of 45 minutes has ended. And as you can see there from the Liverpool supporters, happy as happy can be. 1-0 up. Benteke is getting awfully frustrated with himself. You can just see it. You can see it on his face. You can see it when he shoots and it doesn't go in the back of the net. You can just see that it's playing on his mind a lot. And I'm glad that a subscriber told me in the comment section, Brad, check out how his morale is. And obviously he is very insecure at the moment. So I'm going to leave him on. I don't want to take him off. I want him to score a goal, just for the sake that everything might change then. So let's just jump straight back into the second half. And come on, Benteke. Me and the assistant managers, we believe in you. Show us what you can do. Play it in. Here's Benteke. Come on, Benteke. Cut back. Nicely done. Cut in on your right foot. And it's blocked. This is what's getting frustrating. He knows that he should be putting these past the defenders and past the goalkeeper. Nicely done. Keep that pressure on. Look, Benteke is back further than Coutinho. That's telling me something. He's not where a striker should be. I don't know what is going on, but he is not himself at the moment. Play it in. Here we go. Go on, Benteke. Sneak up behind him. No. No, they're coming forwards. They're coming forwards. No, that's not great. Get it out. Oh, my word. They nearly just leveled 1-1 in the 70th minute. Right, 73 minutes, guys. We're going to make some substitutions. I can definitely tell that the pace of the squad has slowed right down because of energy. As you can see, Coutinho is lacking in a lot of that. So I'm going to bring him off for... let's put Milner in there. And I'm also going to bring Bazaar on for Chan. And I think the last substitution I can do is Danny Ings for Benteke. I'm sorry, Benteke. I know your head's not there, but fingers crossed if we keep playing you, that we can manage to get you back to your scoring ways. Come on, Danny Ings. Can you bag a goal just to put that last nail in the coffin against Norwich in the Capital One Cup? Come on, close him down. Ball comes in. Win that. No. 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 I don't believe it. They've just got through all of our defenders, pretty much. What Kolo Touré was doing, I do not know. Lines it for Milner. Come on, Milner. Play it in back post. And again. Yes, no. Come on. Oh, I don't believe it. I tried to play it in back post and we just could not get it through to save our life. Huge ball comes in. Skirtle. Nicely done. Play it out. And there we go, guys. Referee is blown. Again, we've only managed to win 1-0. Thanks to Roberto Firmino. But you know what, guys? We didn't play well at all. The whole squad together as a team didn't play well at all. If we have a look at the stats, 6 shots, 4 on target, only 39% possession. Absolutely shocking keeping hold of the ball, guys. We kept giving away in easy positions. And once again, Benteke did not find that little sparkle to shine for us. But nevertheless, we are through to the quarterfinals of the Capital One Cup. And I am over the moon with that. But as you can see on the right side, we beat Norwich 1-0. Chelsea beat Aston Villa 1-0, which means we will be facing Chelsea in the quarterfinal of the Capital One Cup. But there we go, guys. That is pretty much going to do it for today's episode. I'm hoping we haven't got any emails of any players, especially Benteke. He's the one I'm worried about at the moment. And as you can see, in just 4 days' time, we will be playing Chelsea in the Premier League, which is never, ever going to be an easy game. And the headline of today is Benteke needs a goal. And to be honest, guys, they're not wrong. I really, really, really hope that he can find his form and he can start scoring some goals for us. And if he can score against Chelsea for us, that'd be absolutely amazing. But nevertheless, guys, if you have enjoyed today's video, please do give it a big thumbs up for me. Drop your comments down below if you're new around here. Click that subscribe button. Don't forget to share this video with your friends and family. And I have been Massive Brad. Peace out.